This is Sony A6000, a camera of my choice. I've been using this camera for 3 years and I have taken around 25,000 photos with this camera. And I don't shoot in burst mode, so I've taken really lot of images from this camera. And somehow this camera has never disappointed me. Every time this camera turns around so good, the images from it are like always so good. And it makes me wonder, does it make sense for anyone to get this camera in 2021? I mean, this model is already discontinued, but some sellers might still have it in stock, and you can always get this as a used camera for a very good price. And if you already have this, should you consider upgrading? Especially how it stands with the latest mobile phones. That's something I'm going to answer in this video. But before that, if you're new here, I'm Suresh Mohan, and this is my page where I talk about photography and cameras. By the way, this section of video that you're watching right now is recorded on iPhone 11. I know iPhone 12 came out, but iPhone 11 is still pretty good. So what do you think about this image quality? Do you think it's pretty good? Because that's the image quality you will get from latest mobile phones. Now I'm going to switch to this camera and show you how the image quality of this camera looks like. Before I switch that, one more thing. The image you're seeing right now, this video you're seeing right now, is recorded on iPhone 11 with 4K 24fps. This will record on 1080p 24fps. So let's see the difference. Alright, so now we are using my Sony A6000 camera with Sigma 16mm f1.4 lens. What do you think? Do you think the image quality has improved? I think the image quality looks pretty good. It looks more soft and it has that sharpness and the background being more blurry, making the video look more cinematic, I guess, if that's the word for it. So mobile phones have come pretty far in terms of their image quality. They have become really good. Their image quality has improved so much, and so many feature sets they have. Like, you can record 4K 60fps on your mobile phones nowadays. On the other hand, cameras like this, like Sony A6000, they are pretty old, and even the new versions that came out, like Sony A6400, they have some new features, but in terms of image quality, there's nothing much changed because they are already pretty good. I know this is not a full frame camera, but I feel this image quality is very good. Even with the kit lens, this camera is so good. You can get really good images with the kit lens. In fact, I used the kit lens for a few years and I took my kit lens everywhere, to all my holidays, and took so many amazing photos with the kit lens. Once I felt more confident with cameras, with understanding of settings, I switched to getting more prime lenses, which have totally taken my photography to another level. Something like Sigma 16mm f1.4 is so sharp with this camera, you can take really awesome landscape photos. And then I have Sony 50mm f1.8 lens, which can be used to take really nice portrait images. So in terms of photography, this camera has never let me down. It's so good. But that said, there are still some issues, and especially issues come in sense of video recording, because this camera is not designed for video, I would say. Like, for example, there's no 4K or color profile. So I mean color profiles as in like S-Log, S-Log 2, S-Log 3, SLG. So people who are into videography might not like it that much. On the other hand, the features that I really miss on this camera is not having a microphone jack. I have to use an external mic connected to my computer to record audio, because I cannot record audio directly on this camera. Like, there is a microphone on this camera, but the audio quality is not that good. So I have to use an external mic connected to some external devices. Then there is no flip screen, so I cannot see myself. I'm just looking at the lens and hoping that the frame is correct. If it's wrong, I have to record it again. And then there is no stabilization. So if you're moving around and you're recording video with it, they will be really shaky. Now, you can have work on for all of them. Like I said, you don't need flip screen. You can connect the camera to a mobile phone and see yourself. Like mobile phone has this app called Imaging Edge, I guess, which you can use to connect your camera and you can see yourself. Sadly, you cannot record video with it. So you can just see yourself, frame yourself, and then go to your camera and record it. For stabilization, you can definitely use a gimbal, And since this is not a very heavy camera, you can look for some lightweight gimbals like Zion Crane M2, which is not as expensive as the other gimbals. And then for microphone, as said, you can record microphone to an external device, to your mobile phone or to your computer. And for color profile, I mean, if you're like me, who doesn't know much of color grading, it's totally fine, right? So in the end, I would say that if you're someone who wants to learn photography, I think this is still a pretty good camera. Although this camera is discontinued by Sony, but you can still look for an old used camera, which will even give you a pretty better deal. And there might be still new cameras available with some sellers who still have stock left, but I would suggest that don't buy this camera as new. I would say if you are into videography, then definitely don't go for this camera. You look for something like Sony 6400, which has microphone jack, flip screen, color profiles. There's still not stabilization, but you can still work around with the gimbal. But if you're into photography, then this camera is still pretty good. And then this is an APS-C line. That means that lenses for this camera are going to be way cheaper than a full frame camera. Now you can definitely use your mobile phone to record videos or even take photos if that's what you already have, right? And the mobile phones these days are really good. So I would suggest go for a camera if you're really dedicated to learn about photography, like you want to control every aspect of a photo, which you can't do it on a mobile phone, then you should go for something like this. Because a mobile phone, you cannot change the lenses, so you won't get different looks, different kind of images that you might want to have, right? With lenses, you can do a lot of interesting stuff. Now, said that, even I use my iPhone to record videos. In fact, last 2-3 videos I recorded on my iPhone only. And I still found issues with it. Most importantly, since I use a native camera which has everything in auto, so I can't control anything. And then when I'm moving around different locations, different angles, I find that the auto settings might be different. Like some settings might have more noise, some might have less noise, some might have different color balance, some might have different shutter speed. Like, because it's auto, it's just difficult to make all this video join together and make it seamless. Yes, I can use a third-party camera app, but when I'm a mobile phone, my point is to have convenience. If I go third-party camera app and do something funny with it, then the convenience is gone. I can use my camera by that time, right? So that's what I think. I think this camera is still pretty good. I would suggest to buy a new one, buy a used one. If you're into video, then definitely don't go for this. Go for something like Canon M50, Sony A6400. But if you want to learn photography, then this camera is definitely good, even 2021. I'm getting a lot of life out of this camera. You can also get it too. So that was my point of view. What do you think? Let me know in the comment. And if you like it, then press a like. And if you don't like it, then please let me know why you didn't like it. Like, what should I do to make it more interesting and more fun, right? So have a nice day. Hope this video was helpful to you. Thank you. See you again.